What's up, Madden 17 fans? My name's Cody, and I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. In today's video, what I want to do is just play an online game and try to help. I think that this is a really good way for you guys to kind of share some of the things that come up in a live tournament-style competitive gameplay. I think it's a lot easier for me to sit without the game playing and teach and tell you that there are all these lessons that you should do, but I think practically this is a lot more helpful because what it does is it shows you exactly step by step what's going on over the course of a live game. So hopefully this series has been helpful. If it hasn't, please let me know in the comments so that I can tweak it or change it or make it better. If you have any suggestions at all, please let me know. But starting out, we're in the Pittsburgh Steelers offensive playbook, and this playbook's going to be coming out. I'm going to have a full offensive scheme ebook on Christmas Day, hopefully. It should be ready by then, so you guys can check that out on Christmas Day. But anyways, guys, what we're really looking to do here is a couple things. The first thing is simply execute. Like, that's the whole key to all this. And so we come to the line, we see, okay, two high safeties, two low corners. This is probably either cover two or cover two man, but because he's manned up over the guys, it's probably cover two. So we go cover two, that's exactly what we get. We're able to check down over the middle. So interesting little defense there. He actually changed into cover three. And see, that's one of those things that is kind of what you learn over time is the good players, what they'll do is they'll make cover twos look like cover threes. And so that changes a lot because you can't, it's not as easy as 1, 2, 3. It's now 1, 2, 3 plus 2 or 3. You know, like, the data points are a little bit skewed, a little bit messed up, honestly, trying to figure out what is what. So that was a decent run there by Derrick Henry. He got out of trouble. He went to cover two man there. What's interesting to me is always to look at that little data point that they give you. They tell you, is he cover two man? Is he cover two? Is he this? Is he that? They give you that data. And so I think that's important because what you can do is you can take it and pair it with your pre-snap hypothesis. It helps you kind of slow down post-snap to kind of really see, like, what did he do? It's like here you'll see there's a $326. Looks like he's setting up a blitz off that right edge. What we're going to do here is we're just going to run it right off the left side. And we weren't able to get anything. Fourth and four. A little stubborn, so I'm going to probably go for this. I just trust this running play. Like, this should work in theory. There it is. Hit it right up the gut. And that's just trusting your offense. I mean, and there it is. There's cover two blitz from Dollar. He probably cross-manned him. Probably cross-manned his players on crossing routes. So that's letting me know that we may need to attack a different side of the field. Like, when we see cross man instantly, like a formation that would really look like it's a cross man. Another thing you got to look at too is, like, if he's doing what I think he's doing, where do I want to attack? Like, what's the open side of the field? There he goes, a little run commit. Interesting little play call. Like, he got kind of tired of us running it as cover two. But you always got to test that data point. I think in my last video, I talked a little bit about that. Like, this idea that you've got to test your data points. Like, there's no other way around it. Like, it's just that simple. Like, what I don't do a good job of all the time is reading the defense. It's probably the thing that I'm worst at. Probably the part of my game on offense that needs to be improved the most is being able to effectively read the defense. Like, that is something I struggle with. And I try to get better. I have all these rules and different things. And so, like, here, if you look at this, looks like he's probably blitzing me off the right edge. So what we're going to do, quick flat route that way. Nope. There's the drag on the backside. So he ran, was that cover three? Yep, cover three zone blitz, what I thought. Let's see here, first and 10. So you can automatically see here, where is he most likely to blitz me from? Like in this situation, looks like he can potentially blitz me off the right edge. So I look to my right, there's my guy. And we're gonna get in for touchdown. And I think that's what this is all about, is that pre-snap hypothesis of like, what is the field tell me? Like, should I go here? Should I go there? Like all those questions, I think they can be answered. Majority of them can be answered by what is the pre-snap read, because most people don't make their defense look the same. But then you'll get into against a good player who makes his defense look the same every time and users and does all these things. That changes it, but I think you're still doing the same thing. Like you're still reading pre-snap. You still do that. Like that's a imperative part of your system. Oh, love of God, catch that ball, Derrick Henry. But you've got to, and I think, because that's the thing is, like, this game, it moves so quick. Like, post-snap is just such a fast deal. Like, I used to want to be able to, like, read the whole field and just hit the open area. And what I'm finding more and more is it's very difficult to do that. Because what happens is you expect one thing to happen, but he calls that hot route or something that just changes it, and you end up throwing, I end up throwing a lot of interceptions, and none of it is because my plays are not open. Normally it's always because it's a bad read. I don't think I've ever thrown an interception because my play didn't work. And that's part of why I'm very, very highly recommending you do just one, like you have one main offense and you don't really change it, and you stick with it and you learn how to adjust it, because what happens is normally your play is actually open, you just don't know that it is because you make a bad read. Post snap reads are what kill an offense. Making a mistake, fullback dive, and the fullback dive is interesting. I'll tell you what, 4-3 under does a good job against against pretty much every run. Like I've not really went up against a run that I'm like worried about not being able to stop when the chips are down. Like normally I can probably stop it. Let's see. Little flood concept there. Flood concept to the left. One thing you do on defense, one thing I do is that you collect data. Like, is he running? So he's an ace twins and he's running this play, and why is he running this play? And all that data. Like, I do a vast amount of collecting. There's that slot under play that everybody loves. He rolls out with his quarterback. Okay, that lets me know that I need to keep a spot. Keep a spy in it. Like when I run that cover too, like I got to keep the spy in, or every type of possible scenario. And that's the thing, like a part of me doesn't want to play user defense if I don't have to. Like if I can just sit and play call, that's optimal, because what happens is, oh wow, could you give me a block? Three guys are right there and one guy block sheds. Like that's ridiculous. But what I was getting back to what I was saying, so what you'll notice is a lot of times I'm trying to figure out how to say this. A lot of people will try to master user control. To me, if I don't have to user someone, what it does is it allows me to watch the routes. And I think that's more important, because if I can figure out what you're trying to accomplish, like more than likely I can do something. Like unless you just got this play that's just insane. Like unless you just got like this crazy, like, you know, deep streak that can only be user defense. Like some people have plays like that. And if you have that, like more power to you. Let's see if we can't get Derrick Henry. Oh, that was probably a stupid read. I thought he could outrun the safety. Smothered me there. I don't know. Cover zero blitz, man. And just everybody's locked. It's crazy. Slant route didn't get open. Normally the slant route does get open there, so that was interesting. But back to what I'm saying about the defense. So like for the most part, like if I don't have to use her, I won't. Like if I can just stay on the D line, that's what I want to do. See if we can make a tackle. That's a big tackle, Calvin Pryor. I totally called the wrong play. I was completely convinced he was going to throw it and just called an all-out pass coverage. Is that cover three? I'll call that cover three. That's a really what that cover three does better than the cover two. It's not a whole lot, but what it does a little, it's like a hybrid. It's like a hybrid between the cover two and the cover three zone blitz Mike will cross. Like that's what I think of when I think of the cover three, the audible, the cover three. We got him. Oh. Slot under, there it is. It's a good play. Slot under is a good play. Wish we wouldn't have turned it over. And the linebackers did not do what I wanted them to. Gosh, that should be a turnover. So right there, so we saw quite a bit of chess being played, and where he really wants to go, if you notice, is that slot under play. Like, that's a good play, and a lot of people like to go to that. What he wants to do is he wants to go to that when the chips are down. Like if it's a down and distance where he's got to get a first down, he's probably going to go to that slot under play more than likely, which is just a basic. I mean, it's a real simple play. It's a very good play, trying to think through like mentally, like how would I. Time is ticking here. Let's see if we can stop it. He wants to go to the slot. Like, that's been his MO. There's the crossing route. Oh, he's what? That's one of the most frustrating things in Madden. Like, he's rolling out, throws it back across his body. Completely oblivious, like has no real read. We locked him up and he just dots us up. Like, that's just crazy to me. Oh, he got us. Dang it, he got me. Frustrating. Shouldn't have called that play. Shouldn't have called cover zero. I should have checked out of it as soon as I saw trips. Dang it. That's a terrible play call. A tough, 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 tough touchdown to give up. That's one of those things where I think through the course of a game you react a little bit emotionally there. So, like, what happened right there was I was frustrated that he just dotted me up for, like, 30 yards. And what I wanted to do was – I really just was pissed, and what I really, really wanted to do was, get an interception or a sack, right? Only problem with that is you can't force that. you can't, as much as I want to make it happen, I can't make it happen. And all I had to do was call my standard goal line defense and probably would have been okay. But I just, you know, to me, I didn't want to do that. Goes cover two man. If he's smart, he'll stay in that cover two man. I'm trying to think how I would beat it, though. Yeah, that's just one of those plays. I just messed up. I called a bad play. On to the next play. So he called cover two man. He's probably going to call the same thing again. Wow, thank you, Eli Manning. Figured out a good way to beat cover two man for like a big gain. Let's try the Steeler cross. Might be able to. Maybe get Philip Dorsett on a deep bomb. Yeah, I haven't quite figured this one out. Just haven't figured out a great way to do it because he backs that coverage off. That's okay. Yeah, I haven't figured out a great way to beat cover two man over the safeties yet. Like from my formation, you know, there's probably a play that I could use, but I don't like working out of more than one formation. Kind of sucks though that, dang, I kind of touch. So I made one mistake on defense and probably two or three on offense there. As far as big mistakes, I threw the interception. Again, you see how these little mistakes like pile up. Interception, blown coverage, bad play call. Those things pile up. And I think a lot of times we don't notice it, but they really do. I mean, they really just pile up. Like, you could, I'm telling you guys, like, it's so easy to not pay attention to making mistakes. Like, if you just try to, in my opinion, it's so vital that you don't make mental mistakes. Normally, most of the game, if you really thought about it, most of the game is mistakes. Most of where you lose games is mental mistakes. It's turnovers. It's calling the wrong defense when you know you shouldn't call it. When you know, like, if you just play your standard coverage, like, and I'm the worst at it. I just recognize it. I just see it, like, over and over again. You watch a game, and what people do is they let one lucky play turn into a touchdown, which is exactly what I did on that drive. Get a little aggressive here. We're going to go hard flat. See if it makes a difference. And we get dotted up. That's okay. It's so interesting to me, like, watching people play sometimes because I think they don't read me at all. Like, you would think. Because, I mean, I haven't went hard flat all game, so you would think that it would be a good call, but then he just runs a curl flat route again. Like, that doesn't make sense to me. But that lets me know, like, he's not going to chips her down. He's going to go with that slot under play, try to hit the slot route. Like, he's hit the slot, I think, on third down or fourth down every time. At some point, you know, I got to adjust. Let's see if he runs this. If he runs it, I'm screwed. Dang it. This guy's got some interesting offensive philosophy. So cover four, I don't know. It's a weird little down. Third and four. Probably going to go to that slot. There we go. Got him. I don't think he's ran that play on third down yet. But it seems like what he does more than not is he goes to the slot. Wide love running back here. Probably going to be on a crossing route. Yep, there we are. Got him. Good D. So we have the crossing route there. Trying to think through, like, where else would he... I mean, that's pretty much everything he's done. Like, he'll look to the curl. Like, he hit us that one time on that one play with that wheel route. But, like, outside of that, it's been 90%. So here he's showing cover two man, right? That's the base defense that he's given me an opportunity to see here. Checks into, I don't even know what he checked into. About got killed with Manning. I don't know what he called right there. Doing a good job of disguising his coverage. This is really getting old with the wheel routes. Like, Madden has just broken them. Like, it's really getting old. Like, I can't even throw the ball to my running back on a check release route to the flat. Like, that's getting a little bit ridiculous. I don't understand that about this game. Give me the first down. Thank you. This is a play I'm trying more and more of a cover two beater. Fitz gonna fits. Caught that on Deion Sanders. Because like cover zero is becoming more of a play call that people like. That we can do here. So see, first and 10. We haven't ran the ball in a little while. We need to run it. He's doing a good job. He's making his defense look the same every time. That was one of the best tackles I've ever seen. Who was that? Doing a good job on defense, I think. He's mixing up his plays. He's making them look the same. That's what makes it tough, right? Because you get a base look, and it's the same look every time, and makes it difficult. So here he's showing a blitz off both sides. There's Danny Amendola over the middle. Oh, I called the wrong play. Oh, wow. Dang. Gotta take your three. Dang it. What a play. What a good defense, man. He's playing good, solid defense. I mean, it's tough. I mean, the thing about it is what he does, what I think no one sees, is he's, again, making it all look the same and, like, running man and then running cover three and running cover two. Like, he's just... It's hard to get a read on the coverage show. And, like, every coverage, something else is open. Whether it's, you know, so if you know the coverage, it makes it easier. That's me. Oh, come on, Josh Norman. But defensively, I felt pretty confident. I mean, I've given up one play, and it was really just a mental mistake. He's had a hard time with the cover two. There's a check down. Expecting that slot under play. Oh, wow. Should have been an interception. Surprised he didn't run that little crossing route. It's like the first time he hasn't ran a crossing route. He's probably going to right here. PA jet sweep with the crossing route. Got him. It's a good defense right there, I think. I mean, pretty solid, like, tendency read, like, crossing routes where he's been wanting to hit me. All right, so offensively now we have to capitalize. Knowing he has three timeouts, knowing he's done a decent job, knowing he's got me once. He's cover zero, blitzed me a couple times. If I score and get one and 7 points, puts the game away. So what we're going to do is go for the knockout punch. This is a little bit of a gamble here. Got him. So right there, he's been doing that where he does like just random coverage shells too, where like he hybrid coverages. And we were able just to catch him. I mean, that Kelvin Benjamin was like my third option. I did not want to go to him. Where I was really looking to target was Fitzgerald on the streak. I thought he was going to go cover two. I mean, he's been going cover two the majority of the game. We're able to get him, get the two-point conversion with Benjamin. That two-point conversion, I think that's a pretty good little play, that steal across. That little route to the tight end does a lot of for us. Okay, so defensively now, this is one of those things where it's like if you do it right, you shouldn't give up. You really should get out of here okay. This should be pretty easy to close out here for the defense. What we like to do in this situation, at least what I like to do, is I like to go to cover six. Except that happened. Dang. I don't understand playmaker. I hate playmaker. I think it's one of the worst features in the game. Like, it's just junkyard football. Like, it's terrible. Me, it's not what I like. I hate it. I hate playmaker, and normally playmaker is what beats me. I don't know why they keep going down on the run like that. I want them to pass commit. Like, that should be an easy interception. That's part of the reason I don't like to use her either, is because when you use her, you tend to kind of get out of position. Because, like, what will happen is you'll jump this route and that route and that route. And Nick, before you know it, they'll throw some kind of crazy playmaker route over the middle. And it just, there's nothing you can do. So this is a kind of a picky. This is one of those downs. You gotta watch here. Got lucky. Totally got lucky to not get sacked. I was trying to hit the tight end on a quick flat route, and for some reason, he just didn't run his route. That's kind of frustrating. what I want to have happen here is I want to hit Dallas Clark on this route. He's probably going to be open. But it keeps making him block, and this is really pissing me off. Keeps making him block. I don't want him to block. Fits. That's part of just knowing. I think one thing that I don't do very well sometimes is I don't always trust myself under pressure. If you trust your reads, you can play under pressure, but you got to trust it. So, anyways, guys, that's the game. I think there's a couple things that you can learn from this game, but the biggest thing, biggest takeaway for me today is just don't make mistakes, man. Try to limit your mistakes. Mental mistakes are often what cause losses. So, just something to think about. So thanks for stopping by, guys. I hope the video was helpful. If it was, please let me know. And again, if you have any questions,